For the last few years, Laurie and Jennifer have led walks to Widecombe Fair, meeting at Houndtor car park. Although starting together, the walks take differing routes, but we'll meet at Widecombe Fair for lunch.
I'm leading the longer walk and Jennifer's leading the shorter walk. So, anyways, you know we went to Widecombe Fair. Last time, I made you sing it. I'm not going to make you sing it, but you'll get a copy of the words and you can sing it to yourself on the go. That's a passion round. Meanwhile, I will play you the tune on the mouth organ, and then you can.
Thank you. She's going to play it on the mouth organ.
Now that Laurie has finished her rendition of the famous tune, let's get back to the walk and have a look at the route we'll be taking. From the car park, we'll head towards Jay's grave. It's then on to Natsworthy Manor, and after a coffee break, we'll head down the road towards Widecombe, but turning off up a farm track below Honeybag and Chingwell Tors. Then it's on to Bonehill Rocks, before descending into Widecombe itself. We'll then head back towards Bonehill Rocks, across Bonehill Down, and on to Holwell Lawn, past Greatore Rocks, and back to the car park via Houndtor itself, about 7¾ miles.
Yeah, you did indeed. Joan says it was absolutely boiling.
I don't think you'd get a better day for today's walk. The sun is shining, and I expect there'll be a lot of people at Widecombe Fair today.
Lean down.
I think most of us today have walked this route many times. And I personally never get tired of the wonderful moorland scenery.
In the distance is Honeybag Tor. Gradually making our way to Jay's grave.
I was carrying an enormous box or something.
The history of Kitty Jay's grave is fairly well known.
By Jay's grave?
And again, I've passed this way many times before, and always there are flowers, or money, or children's toys placed upon the grave. By whom? I've no idea. But it just shows people do care.
Oh, it's lovely walking through this shaded area. Get away from the heat a little bit.
Right direction.
last but not least,
just as we reach Knatsworthy Manor, our second group of walkers are just leaving. Just time to say hello, and they're on the way. Meanwhile, for our group, it's time to have a coffee break.
Looks like a drinks break.
The next section of a walk involves a little bit of road walking for about a mile, and after a cup of coffee, everyone is ready to continue.
Making our way down towards Widecombe, but turning off to go up over Chinkwell Tor, about halfway down.
The route up this stone farm track is quite steep and very rough. It leads back onto the moor below Honeybank Tor.
Can you see the levitating tree, Laurie?
The original plan was to turn off this track and head up over the rise and on to Chinkwell Tor. But given the choice, our walkers decided to avoid this climb and head towards Bonehill Rocks to reach Widecombe Fair a little earlier.
Looking down at a very misty Widecombe, particularly Widecombe Church. There we go. Going down below Bonehill Rocks.
This particular tour is very popular with climbers, with many types of differing climbing problems to overcome.
We're going to go down the road now and down into Widecombe. Bell Tor. Bell Tor and part of Chinkwell.
On the way down the road to Widecombe, there is quite a smart private cottage with an unusual add-on.
Look at the posts holding up the lean-to for the garage roof, or the lean-to roof.
The earliest written records so far about the origins of Widecombe Fair state that Uncle Tom Cobbley and his friends left Sprayton in 1802 to go to the well-known Widecombe Fair. I expect everyone knows the tune, and maybe some of the lyrics, but who wrote it? The answer to that question is Sabine Baring Gould, who was born in January 1834 and died in 1924 at the age of 89. He was an Anglican priest and had, believe it or not, 15 children. I'm surprised he had any time left to write songs. The rendition you are now going to hear is by a friend of mine in the Isle of Man.
Tom Pierce, lend me your grey mare. All along down, along out, along me. I wants to go to Widecombe Fair, where the brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Dalwyn, Harry Hawk, all Uncle Tom Copley and all. All Uncle Tom Copley and all. And when shall I see again my grey mare? All along down, along out, along Lee. By Friday soon, or Saturday noon, when no brewer, Jan Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, all Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all. And Friday came and Saturday noon, all along down, along out, along me. But Tom Pierce's old mare hath not trotted home, with Bill Brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all.
Kids playing.
So Tom Pierce, he got up to the top of the hill, all along down, along out, along me. He seen his old mare down a making her will, with the brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all. So Tom Pierce's old mare, her took sick and died, all along down, along out, along Lee. And Tom, he sat down on the stone and he cried, with Bill Brewer, Jan Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all. But this isn't the end of this shocking affair. All along down, along out, along we. Although they be dead of the horrid career of Bill Brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all. When the wind whistles cold in the moor of a night, all along down, along out, along Lee, Tom Pierce's old mare doth appear ghastly white, with Bill Brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all. And all the night long be heard skirling groans, all along down, along out, along Lee, from Tom Pierce's old mare and her rattling bones, with Bill Brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Damelwyn, Harry Hawk, old Uncle Tom Copley and all. Old Uncle Tom Copley and all.
It's hoped you enjoyed my taste of Widecombe Fair. An hour isn't very long to do it justice. The answer is to come along and see for yourself next year. Time to get back to our walking group to continue our walk. I think we're just about ready to go. Unfortunately, the first part of our return journey to Hound Tor is back up the hill to Bone Hill Rocks.
Yes, no, I'm trying to find you.
He's a chap.
The groups are going to separate once more. We're now making our way across Bonehill Down to Holwell Lawn. Looking between the disused quarry areas, we can see hay tall rocks.
Hay tall in the distance. And there we are. Veering off the normal walk and heading in a circle, I think.
Tom Pierce, lend me your grey mare. All along down, along out, along
I
want to go to Widecombe Fair.
And Bracken's quite high this time of year.
Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Dalwyn, Harry York, all Uncle Tom Cobley and all. All Uncle Tom Cobley and all.
Of course,
when shall I see again my grey mare? All along down.
How much wind noise is coming through on this?
Today has been especially good, with the weather being quite fantastic. My thanks to Tony Archibald for allowing me to play his version of the Widecombe Fair song.
When Friday came and Saturday noon, all along down, along out, along we. But Tom Pierce's old mare hath not trotted home, with Bill Brewer, Jack Stewart, Peter Gurney, Peter Davy, Dabblewin, Harry York, old Uncle Tom Cobley and all, old Uncle Tom Cobley and all.